This segment of Domarva Life is brought to you by Tidal Health.
Two arms, two legs, 10 fingers, 10 toes, obviously very important parts of the human body. Even so, those who are missing vital extremities, many of them manage to adapt.
But losing a leg can oftentimes be avoided with proper health management, and that's what a program at Tidal Health Nanticoke delivers. With us this afternoon is Dr. Alfred Hurley. He's an interventional cardiologist with Tidal Health Cardiology in Seaford. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
So can you tell me, can you give me a thumbnail of what an interventional cardiologist does?
So an interventional cardiologist is essentially a fully trained cardiologist with the specialization and focus on procedures of the heart. Those procedures are approached from the percutaneous or endovascular approach, and that's just a fancy way of saying minimally invasive. So we're not surgeons. I don't do any cutting or anything on anybody, but with patients that either have bad heart disease, bad peripheral vascular disease, the goal is to go in and see if we can open up blockages. Usually we approach with little needle pokes, whether that's in the wrist or in the leg. Minimally invasive, once again, no cutting. I'd like to say that because patients always worry about surgery. Most of what we do is around fixing blockages. So you have arteries, which are big tubes, plumbing, and you can get plaque buildup, and that can narrow that artery. So a lot of times the goal is to either use a combination of balloons or stents to open up those blockages. In the more recent times, our field has kind of expanded where we, you know, we'll fix holes in the heart, we'll replace valves and things, all from a percutaneous or minimally invasive approach.
Wow.
But still, the majority of what we do is around blockages and plaque buildup.
Wow. Okay, so you, heart disease, do genetics play a role in heart disease?
Yeah, so short answer is yes. It's not quite at the point where, you know, we're doing a battery of genetic tests and we focus therapy specifically to genetics. Usually when you're thinking of genetic testing, it's more from the congenital heart disease standpoint, where people are born with different type of malformations of the heart. But undoubtedly, genetics play a role, even with plaque buildup, coronary artery disease, and peripheral vascular disease. You know, anytime we see people in the office, we're always trying to assess risk. So when people are talking about chest pain, how long it's been going for, how severe it is, whether they have poorly controlled blood pressure, cholesterol, diabetes, we're trying to assess risk, and we're trying to figure out, does this patient warrant medicines? Does this patient warrant a procedure? Does this patient warrant testing? And family history or genetics plays a big role with that. You know, if I see a patient in my office in their 40s, which I typically consider a low-risk patient, and they have chest pain, I treat that patient very differently if they come in and tell me that their father passed away at age 45 from a heart attack. They are in a different risk profile. So I have a lower threshold to order testing, start them on medicines, prevention, you know, those kind
of
things.
You said peripheral vascular disease.
Yes.
What is that? Who is a likely candidate for coming up with that?
Right. So short answer is anybody, right?
Okay.
But the people who are high risk, you know, diabetics and smokers.
What is peripheral?
So peripheral vascular disease is essentially buildup of plaque in the arteries. And that's the peripheral is any artery essentially outside of the heart.
Got it.
So that could be the neck, the upper extremity, the lower extremity. And you know, the big push now is early awareness of the issue. You know, very commonly, I have patients that come and they say, you know what, I'm not having pain in my legs. I can walk fine, not having problems at all. Why do I care if I have a little bit of plaque buildup? And I understand the sentiment. You know, in all patients that are newly diagnosed, only 5.5% of those will actually have classic symptoms, you know, when it comes to leg pain and things of that sort. However, there is a strong correlation between disease in the arteries of the legs and arms and disease of the heart. We have means of doing screening through the office. There's a test called an ankle brachial index where we place blood pressure cuffs in the arms and the legs. So patients with an ABI of 0.8, we'd consider that pretty solidly in the mild category. Those patients share a very similar prognosis to some of the worst breast cancers.
Oh my.
A patient with the ABI of 0.4, which is by far critical, very, very severe peripheral vascular disease, that prognosis is very similar to some of the worst lung cancers. And we don't typically talk in these terms, right?
Right.
But the key there is that these are patients that are not on treatment, not on prevention, not on medicines. And that's why early identification of the issue plays such a big role, because if you can get people on medicines early, if you can screen for risk factors, that risk goes markedly down. So there's plenty of options. Yeah.
So you lead the Save a Limb program at Title Health Nanticoke. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us a little bit what that is?
Yeah, so Save a Limb is directed to the more severe of those patients that I just described. SAVE stands for Stop Amputation of Vital Extremities. And the whole goal is to try and prevent amputations. It's very much a coordinated effort with the podiatrists, the foot doctors in the area, family primary care physicians, endocrinologists. But the purpose of Save a Limb is it's meant to be an access point to quickly get patients from that first point of contact to us. Right. You know, very similar to the way we work on hearts. We have a STEMI program. So if someone has an emergency heart attack, we get them in the hospital, get their blockage opened within the hour.
We could talk about this for the rest of the
show. Sorry.
No. Yeah, thank you for that. Yeah. We appreciate that. Do we need to get a referral through our doctor or?
Yeah, so you can call the number yourself. I'm a big proponent of people having primary care physicians because they're great for screening and trying to figure out the best and most appropriate place. So, but for sure, if you notice symptoms on your own, definitely call and we can kind of point you in the right direction.
And we're going to have that phone number and all the information about Title Health Cardiology on our website, DomarvaLife.com. Dr. Alfred Hurley, thank you so much.
Thank you,
very fascinating stuff.
Thank you very much for having me.
No kidding.